We're in Frameworks, Volume 5, and we're Study 14, looking at what we might call the laver, or really a bath of water that was there in the tabernacle environment. We're trying to understand how Jesus gives us help. And that big bath of water is telling us that Jesus gives us, by the Spirit, a washing that's an inside-out washing. We know how to wash our bodies when we've got dirty, but how can we wash the inside of us when we're dirty inside? And the dirt that's inside us is a different kind of depth and problem. And we can do all sorts of things to try and make ourselves feel better inside, but to be truly washed and made clean and made new inside, a new heart, a new mind, a new being, that we cannot do. But Jesus can do that by the Spirit. And that bath of water that was there at the ancient tabernacle was all about that. So what it was, that if you imagine a person who wanted to join the ancient church, and there might have been all these people of different nations and continents even who might come, and they'd see that huge pillar of cloud and fire pointing down to the center of the ancient church camp. And as they approached, and they might see initially people on the outside who were unclean, and they'd get to know them and then be brought in. And if they were a male, one of the first things that would happen if they wished to join the ancient church is they'd be circumcised. And that bit of flesh, particularly from that part of the body, where we imagine we can produce new life. So that from that part of the body, this little bit of flesh would be cut off. And that was the mark of joining into church family. And the reason for that, it sounds an odd thing to do, but if we think a little bit, because that part of the body, we believe we can produce new life. There's this realization that I cannot produce new life, not the totally new kind of life that we need. We can produce like human children, but those children have the same messed up humanity that we have. And it looks like a brand new life when we see a little baby. But that baby's actually got inside them all the mess of humanity, all the problems, and they're a dying human from the moment they're conceived, the dying of time is against them sort of thing. So the really new kind of life that we need, life that lasts forever, that's pure, that's the life of God, we can't produce that. So that cutting off that bit of flesh was really saying, my strength, my capacities, my options cannot save me. I have to turn away from my humanity and I need a different one. I'm cutting off my natural humanity and I need a different kind of one. So in they would come, and then we've thought about that bronze altar, the sense of confessing sins and having that atoned for, forgiveness, all that comes with that. But if we pass through towards the tabernacle itself, there's the bronze altar, but then there's this bath of water, and the priests would wash there, and the sacrifices would be washed there. And there's this, the point of that is when the atonement's made, when there's been a way for sin to be forgiven, the next thing sequentially in that visual presentation of the universe and how to fix it is this bath of water, as if to say, now when sin is dealt with, then there's a way to have a brand new humanity. And the Bible speaks about that as the circumcision was this physical sign of cutting off the old humanity and needing a new one. That is in an Old Testament physical sign, but in the New Testament there's baptism, where you wash with water, and the Bible links those two together because they're both making the same point. We need to get rid of the old and wash into something new. We need to be washed at the fundamental level to become new and clean and fresh. And so that's when now we don't ask a person to cut off the flesh in that way. when a person joins church now, male or female, they have this sign of baptism, this sense of dying to the old humanity and being washed, resurrected into a new humanity. And there's lots of scriptures about that. Ezekiel 36 from verse 25, where the Lord says, I'll sprinkle clean water on you and you shall be clean. I'll cleanse you from all your filthiness and from your idols. I'll give you a new heart and put a new spirit within you. Can you see that there? The washing is all tied with having a new kind of human heart and mind, free of the old mess and the deceitful desires and the corruption and the filth that's within us. There's so many scriptures about it. Look at Romans chapter 6, where again that idea of a baptism, washing, is all tied to having a brand new kind of human life. All of that is symbolized in that bath of water that was there. And in fact, in Titus 3, verses 3 to 7, it's this lovely thing where it talks about the Lord Jesus that saves us through the washing of rebirth and renewal by the Holy Spirit. The washing of new birth and renewal. So, as we think about that bath of water there in the ancient church, in the books of Moses, what we need to be thinking about is that sense that sometimes we all feel the brokenness that's inside us, the filthiness of our thoughts and desires. And if we're not yet a Christian at all, that can just feel overwhelming and hopeless. And yet we need to know, no, actually, this Lord Jesus doesn't just give us psychological tricks to think differently or not feel bad about how our mess inside. He can actually change the mess inside, change us from the inside out, and give us a brand new kind of humanity. He can wash us, not just outside, but inside.